The Carolina Tambourg is with 3 million insurers, the number 7 on the German market. Next slide. Around about 26 million people are insured by the Hul AOK group. The AOK represents insurers and patients at the same time, and we have to balance the different interests to exempt, for example, of low premium and an excellent health care. We are responsible for more than 92 billion euro. That means a high degree of responsibility and professionalism. The AOK Rheinland-Hamburg provides a multiplicity of path-breaking integrated care contracts in oncology, neurology, cardiology, psychiatry, orthopedics, and pediatrics. The measurement of quality, cost, patient satisfaction, and treatment effects are important criteria for our management. With around 100 local offices in our region, we understand the local requirements and needs. We can combine top-down and bottom-up perspectives. We like to know and understand the needs of our insurers. We offer our patients second opinion by our medical competence center. That means specialists in Germany with very, very high reputation. And by far the most frequently and second opinion are in orthopedic surgery and in oncology. For people with severe diseases, we offer a patient coaching program. Nowadays, there is no company without research and development. Of course, we are also engaged in research and development. Next slide, please. This slide shows the correlation between income and the age of the first manifestation of cancer. Lower income means an earlier first manifestation. It is symptomatic and not acceptable for us that the social status has such a strong impact on health. Next slide, please. Remarkable is the convergence and interplay of different technologies, bio and gene technology, wet and tissue engineering, artificial intelligence. The convergence of these technologies gives the process a tremendous momentum and extraordinary power. That's the reason that we live in the golden era of pharmaceutical research and development. Next slide. The different streams of omics enable a better understanding of tumors. Next slide. Tumor profiling with NGS have a better understanding of tumor mutation and burden, and connected with platforms, national platforms or European platforms, and artificial intelligence connected have impact of the strength and the power of diagnostic, and then the sequences of use and ranking of pharmaceutical drugs. This could change, in some cases, our perception of drugs. It's really important dynamic behind. Next slide. Mm-hmm. The amount of the budget for statutory health insurance is 243 billion. It's not far from the total budget of the state. For pharmaceutical, we spend around about 43 billion, 80%. It's not a big difference what we spend for outpatient care, specialist and general practitioner. It's 45. And for oncology drugs, the expenses are around about 7 billion. This is 70% of the drug budget. That is a considerable amount. Next slide, please. Next. This slide shows the percentage of patient treatment in specialized certified cancer center. And if there are so high expenses for cancer drugs, then we expect that it has really clear benefit for the patient. But we have different challenges. A substantial number of patients are not treated in specialized certified cancer center, unfortunately, in normal, ordinary hospitals. That means a clear loss of years of survival and quality of life. That's a problem. Only in breast cancer, 82% of the patients are treated in specialized certified cancer center. And inter- and multidisciplinarity and the routine of surgery are very important. In the specialized certified cancer center, there's the best knowledge available. They must have the leadership for drug regimen and in clinical research. And it's the right place to introduce new drugs. Also for rare disease, it is really important to have competent center and specialized center because diagnosis in good time, best treatment options and so on. Next slide, please. This figure shows a comparison of the cost domestic product between US, Germany and Denmark. 60.9 in US, 11.2 in Germany and 10.5 for Denmark. Next slide, please. If you look then at the per capita spending on medicine, there are dramatic differences. US spent $1,220, Germany spent $823, and Denmark $318 capita per year. Do you think that in Denmark, with 1/3 of the cost compared to Germany, the inhabitants of Denmark are treated worse than in Germany? I don't believe that. And if next slide, please. And if you look at the earnings before interest and taxes of pharmaceutical manufacturer, then you find impressive numbers like Biogen or Roche. Next slide. So rare expensive drug. So here one story. So Zolgensma US for around sells for $2 million. And the starting point of Zolgensma was an initiative of parents to save the life of her daughter. The parents came across a doctor, Brian Kasper, who works in the Nationwide Children's Hospital in the West State of Ohio. The parents founded to fund the research foundation and raised over 2.3 million donations in 2 years alone. Then they were the main financier until the FDA allows the first clinical trial for babies in 2013. After this, financial investor came, founded AveXis, and took over the product. In 2018, AveXis was sold to Novartis for $8.7 billion. So the idea of public-private partnership is not that the public pays and the private have the financial benefit. And the question is, what is the reason for this enormous price? Cost for R&D? No. Some friends of the pharmaceutical industry told me they would roll the dice. So, next slide. The creative imperative, a wording from the Chancellor Angela Merkel, it's really not so easy to find successful new drugs. But nowadays, we have the best circumstances for R&D. You live in the golden age of pharmaceutical industry. Next slide. Also, the question, is there any pseudo-innovation? Of course. There's something like that. Innovation is only an innovation. It is an improvement of healthcare for the patient and insurer. Innovation means also to separate the wheat from the chaff. This is the work of the GBA and IQWiG. And there are innovation with higher efficacy and lower cost. And there are innovation with higher efficacy and higher price. And innovation must not be necessarily expensive. Next slide, please. It is therefore important at the beginning to record the quality of a product, to check the actual need, and only check then the cost. There's a big difference if you buy a fresh pressed orange juice or an artificial one. In 2003 and earlier, we recognized the need to set up a highly professional institute for innovation management. In 2004, the Independent Institute for Quality and Efficiency in Healthcare IQWiG was established. The NICE, the National Institute for Health and Care Excellence, founded in 1999, was a British model for the German Institute for Quality and Efficiency in Healthcare. So this was the leading idea. IQWiG, in this time, different tasks to produce information for the public and patients, assessment for treatment guidelines, recommendation for disease management guidelines, scientific assessment of the benefit, quality, and cost. The management of the institute is appointed in agreement with the Federal Ministry of Health. The IQWiG is financed ultimately from the contribution of the member of all statutory health insurance, public. And IQWiG requires a commission from the Joint Field Committee. The IQWiG makes benefit assessment of a drug as a recommendation for the Joint Field Committee, which is responsible for the decision-making. Sometimes there's a difference between recommendation and decision-making. of the financial committee in the benefit assessment. For example, in the level of benefit. Frau Lieberman knows this very well. And and historically, the IQWiG has needed a second attempt. This is not atypical in politics. Only with the AMNOG legislation in 2011 did track evaluation really pick up speed. In second attempt, the AMNOG procedure was influenced by the Scottish Medical Consortium, and the different levels of benefit rating were influenced by the French system. Frau Lieberman has shown the different levels. The Joint Field Committee established also in January 2004. It's like a small legislator. And you see the five representatives of the health insurance. You see the five representatives from the care provider, like hospitals, like physician, association of physician, and three impartial members, including chair, and also a patient organization without the vote. The advantage of this model: every decision of the Federal Joint Committee has broader legitimacy because the relevant organization was involved. So it's have a broader acceptance in the society. Next slide. The more things Ms. Dr. Lieberman have told you something about the benefit assessment, negotiation, and research, we have a clear division of tasks. Assessment of drugs on additional benefit compared to the benefit of an appropriate comparator by the Joint Federal Committee. Free pricing in Germany was replaced by negotiation between manufacturer and national umbrella or association of the statutory health insurance funds. So we have really separated between benefits assessment and negotiation. And with the market authorization by, for example, by European Medicine Agency, the pharmaceutical manufacturer can launch at the same time the new drug in Germany. Also at the time, the pharmaceutical manufacturer has to present a dossier with all clinical relevant data to the Joint Federal Committee. In Germany, dossier and the validity of the data and trial design have a high relevance. A lot of companies failed here because IQWiG and GBA is very critical, and I think it's correct. First 6 months benefit assessment includes a report as a recommendation from IQWiG and a hearing procedure and resolution on the benefit. So three months. And the resolution is a part of, for example, a pharmaceutical directive, includes additional benefit over an appropriate comparator, number of patients, requirements of quality assured administration, cost of treatment, also in comparison to the appropriate comparator. The benefit rating influences the negotiation process. So if you have no benefit, you have not a good starting point for negotiation. And 6 months after negotiation between umbrella offices, you have the price. So Germany is very, we talk to one another. You have hearings, you have talks, negotiation like this. And so cost-benefit analysis are not in the focus. We have no qualities like in the UK. The British National Institute for Health and Clinical Excellence, so-called quality-adjusted life years. Qualities are not really innovative-friendly. They are relatively rigid. And also important is that the physician information system software allows a quick transfer between Joint Federal Committee benefit assessment to the physician and to the patient. So this is also progress in the German system. Next slide. So I think this is not, I think it's also mentioned from Dr. Lieberman, so really important mortality, overall survival, morbidity and safety, adverse events and quality of life. And you have what is special in the CERM system for orphan drugs. You have the 50 million barrier. So if you have not more money with this than 50 million, it's a rare disease, then you have antiquifile benefit by law. In principle, this system shows a high flexibility and high degree of fairness. It's a learning system. Next slide, please. So you have a major, considerable, and minor benefit like this. But perhaps also I give the quality of evidence is important. If it's a proof, it's an indication or only a hint. Next slide, please. And you see also the distribution of this. So you have 58% have no benefit. Next slide, please. So what you see is in Germany has the most, this figure shows clear that Germany has the most often drugs which we reimbursed. 93% or 133 often drugs are now in the German market without time delay. This is a special feature in Europe, but rare diseases are not really rare. But there's a risk that pharmaceutical manufacturer has strategic view of this topic. The regulation of this topic is not so difficult. It is possible to decrease, for example, the 50 million barrier for often drugs. So if you see it's a bad development, we can do this. Or we can introduce other additional requirements. Next slide, please. What you see also now in the discussion, there's a dispute sometimes in the public. So there was a letter of ICRIC to the European Medicine Agency postulate that EMA, European Medicine Agency, should support the international research community by publishing clinical study reports on medicine and vaccine trials at the time of market authorization, or immediately at this time. So I think it's a very clever letter. And you see, it's also a lot, the other side is vaccines and drugs in this market have a high volume, so it's also very sensitive. On the other side, you see it's sometimes a challenge for country to develop common and global responsibility. So you see some countries would like come first. Next slide, please. My conclusion, the Amnox procedure with benefit assessment and price negotiation based on experience of different countries have high flexibility and high degree of fairness. It's a robust and learning system, very important in a time where we have a high speed of innovations. So, and what is the alternative? You can also think about price fixing by state. This was also in Germany in discussion. But I think really you need a really excellent institute, and the principle with the dossier is a very good system, and you find similar things also in other countries. And Germany is in this case a little bit, France and Germany have a little bit the same philosophy and strategy. Further improvement or development needs, so what we like to have, building of a fund for independent clinical trials. Often drugs, it's a little bit ambivalent, so perhaps we need also better data. So the question is, if you have no data, perhaps you implement a European-wide registry. And also it's a challenge in the system, the establishing dimension of time. This is also a challenge in oncology. If you have gene therapy or like this, or like Kymriah or CAR technology like this, high cost, then you need to think a little bit of the also of the time. And this means also this dimension, it's the reason we have sometimes outcome-based contracts, for example. So, and the last point is we have to strengthen the negotiation power, because pharmaceutical manufacturer works globally, and we need also a little bit power to stabilize the balance. Thank you very much.